Would you like to play first? Yes. Would you like to keep this hand? No. Unfortunately, this is not playable. Even if one of these was a red source, it'd be very sketchy. This hand just doesn't do anything without getting very lucky. It needs to draw things to do early, and it needs to draw land. So you can't keep those. This is a little bit better, due to the filtering with Temple of Enlightenment. Would you like to mulligan? No, this is okay. Keep that on top. And we're in okay shape. We do need like a Fiend Slayer Paladin at some point though, in order to really stabilize. Or maybe a quicken so we can go quicken into mortars and protect our life total on his next turn. But we'll also have render silent, so there's that. And this isn't going bad for us at all. Render silent, whatever he's doing here on turn 3. Lifebane Zombie. I think that's worth countering. Most of his threats I can mortars later. So get in while the getting is good. Ding. So next turn I'll be able to go that guy and mortars, and then untap an Elspeth from a reasonable life total. This looks like an Ixava. Yep. So if I had let the Lifebane Zombie resolve, I would have had to mortars it to protect my life total, and then I wouldn't have had the 3 mana up for the render silent. Whereas this way, I get to mortars it and play a Fiend Slayer Paladin. And I don't have like a right now. I'd have a render silent. Render silent. Okay, I would have a render silent stuck in my hand, and I'd be taking damage from something. Oh, this Fiend Slayer Paladin is good. I have no clue if it actually will be or not. This looks like a dragon. Sure. It's nice that the Elspeth can just deal with a dragon. I kind of like that. I'm going to shack myself for the steam vents in case I draw Mizzy Mortars and need to kill multiple creatures next turn. There's no real reason to have another blue-white source untapped. Yeah, I like this. Mizzy Mortars really adds a lot to the deck. Like, it gives me an answer to Blood Baron and Stormbreath Dragon that typical blue-white decks don't have. And I actually like Mizzy Mortars even better than, like, Doomblade sort of effects. Spike Jester, probably just gonna kill Elspeth here. That's maybe a reason to hold the Fiend Slayer Paladin back, but there's so many creatures in his deck that I don't actually, that don't, holding the Paladin back wouldn't have actually done anything there. For example, if he goes Chandra's Phoenix, then I just feel like an idiot because I just gave up 2 life. And 2 life could matter. Whoa. Skullcrack. Do I care about that? I do, actually. It's five damage. And the way he races me is he gets it in now, like before I've had a chance to attack with the Paladin a lot. That is awesome. Yeah, I lose 1 life for every attack and then him hitting me. But he was taking 2 life in the exchange, so I thought racing was fine. And now we drew another Fiend Slayer Paladin, so it's just better than fine. I don't even know what possible outs he could have. He could have another Stormbreath Dragon. That would stymie our attack. I should probably have held this Steam Vents in case I drew Izzet Charm and wanted to filter it. But Izzet Charm has other things to do, like I could kill a Spike Jester. Or shock a Stormbreath Dragon if he. Oh no, Stormbreath Dragon has Pearl White. So there's the first strike from Fiend Slayer Paladin would be irrelevant. Definitely not going to play this island, especially since if I play it from my hand, it's untapped. So if I draw Sphinx's Revelation, it's an untapped land for that anyway. I guess overloaded Mizzy Mortars could take the Paladins out of the equation. Now, if he double blocks one, I actually lose it. And then I would kill. What would I kill? Probably the Spike Jester, and then just leave him with a Phoenix, and he'd be at 2 life. I think that's fine. Yeah, he has to double block here, so... Oh, this is weird. I don't really understand this. But, you know. I guess he figured I was going to blow him out with a removal spell if he double blocked. Yeah, I just don't really understand, I guess. This Lifebane zombie seems like it's fishing for information, of which it doesn't really find any. So that I'm willing to hold lands. Again, more for the Is It Charm than for a potential bluff. I think that's way more important. Okay, is there anything we need to change on the draw? I don't think our strategy changes on the draw at all. I think this is fine. Fiendslayer Paladin was a house. Oh, man. I might, on the draw, hold Mizzium Mortars longer. Like, if I have a chance to either Is It Charm or Mizzium Mortars a creature on turn 2, I'm more likely to Is It Charm it. And in fact, because he showed me Dragon, I think I want to bring in a Supreme Verdict for one of these Detention Spheres. Because it can actually kill a dragon. And then I'll have Quicken into another sorcery that kills the dragon that turn. The turn that he top decks it. So that's relevant too. There's multiple reasons that I want it over the fourth Detention Sphere. And then I think the rest of this is fine. We could cut a Jace. I think leaving one in there is reasonable.